What's up, YouTube? Stonebraker Does Stuff here with another video. We're going to piggyback off of the Mike Tyson videos that have done really well. Not only did I struggle with Mike Tyson, but there were a lot of Nintendo games that I struggled with. Actually, the first gaming system that I remember struggling with was the one you're going to see right here. The Atari. The Atari was the first system that I remember playing as a kid. I remember my cousin having it. He had Pitfall, he had Pac-Man, and he had Pong, and I was terrible at all three of them, especially Pitfall. So the Atari was my number one system up until right there, baby. Late 80s, Nintendo Entertainment System. All kinds of memories. Mario, Duck Hunt, US Track and Field, Arch Rivals, Bases Loaded. Absolutely love the system. I believe it was something my father purchased for my brother and him and me to play as a 3 and 4 year old. But as I recall, I probably played it more than any of them. And I did have a lot of games growing up as a kid. As I got older, I sucked at, I'm gonna be honest. One of the games I sucked at is Double Freaking Dribble. The Boston Frogs I could not beat, but that's another story. So right now we're gonna talk about three games. We're gonna do a retro game challenge. Can I do in 2023 what I could not do that basically could say anywhere from about 1989 to 1993? So three games, Pro-Am, Paperboy, and then of course Top Gun. I think you know what some of the issues is with all three of these games. So we're gonna start off with the first one right here. And it is Top Gun. If you played this game, it is based on the 1986 Tom Cruise movie, where there's a lot of shirtless people, a lot of gun power, and some volleyball. In this game, I recall easily never being able to land a ship and dying before I reach the second level. Can I do it now? Let's find out. All right, before this madness begins, first off, let's just admire this start screen. Beautiful coloring. I'm right there in my jet. I'm extending to heights unknown to anybody but myself and my soon-to-be victims. Beautiful start screen. Now we even get the flashing. Now look at this. It's like it's captured in person. I'm letting the fire roar. Looks like they've got me on a mission. They want me to train first. I don't know why I need to train. I was born to do this. Give me all of them. I'll take all the missiles. I'll take everything. I don't even need missiles. Give me just nets. Give me nets full of little octopuses. All right, so we're going to take off here. See how well we do right here. Top left, altitude. Bottom right, speed. Top right, my missiles. All kinds of stuff. Look at that realistic dashboard. There you see me right now trying to do a barrel roll. You know, getting my wings underneath me. Shooting another. Oh, okay. Here they come. Look at that. Direct hit. He was dead too. You didn't see it, but I shot him down. You can see my movements at the bottom left in a little square. But why look at that when you can see me just absolutely firing on enemies? I believe this is training and they real people, so they're letting me kill people just to train. That's what the US Navy does. That's how important I am. And there you see, look at this. Can I get him? Oh, bullseye. Bullseye again. There's another bull. Is that four bullseyes? I told you I don't need any missiles. Uh-oh. We got a missile. We got some coming at me. Uh-oh. What am I going to do? Go left. All right. Hard right. We got to drop down below the clouds. Look at this. I'm moving left and right. I know what I'm doing. I'm a natural at this. I'm not just a volleyball player. I'm not here for volleyball. I'm here to serve my country. And I'm serving him well. Now we got some black. This UFOs? Are we shooting at UFOs? Oh man, someone's got me. I gotta get out. Get out. Get out. There we go. Okay. Someone had me in their sights. Luckily, I was talented enough to avoid them. I got two that got away. I let them get away. I knew they had families at home. I showed mercy. That's part of being a killer. You gotta have mercy sometimes. But I'm not gonna have mercy on this guy because he's shooting me first. Alright, I gave him a little mercy. Look at this. Oh, a couple more got a while. They got me in danger. Get out, get out. Come on. Come on. You know, if we got all those fancy names, I think Stonebraker, I don't even need a fancy name. My name is the coolest name ever. So I'm out here just kind of winging it. I got my AirPods turned on. I got some tunes in my ears. I'm just casually killing people for training. As a direct hit. Boom. I think I've done enough training. Look at this. I'm getting cocky. I'm flying between the clouds, going up. Look at this altitude. About to hit 30,000 feet. Going after them Independence Day aliens, I believe. Nope, they got me in their sights again. They've done that quite a few times, but they've not understood that I have no problem getting out of their sights. So far, we're doing pretty good. As a kid, I believe I had no issues with this as well. So I think we were good there. But the issue is I could never land the jet. And we're going to try right here. Okay, here we go. This is at least 32 years since I've done this. I've never been able to land this, not once. I have a better shot of walking into a Menards hardware store and finding a scarecrow named Wilbur telling me hello. All right, focus. I need to focus. I need to get my speed down. So we're going down 430. We need to go right, a little left. I need to get that speed down. I'm still at 380. I need to get that way down. That ship's coming in close and I've never landed. Okay, speed down. Let's just let the music roll. I need to focus here. Left, right. Altitude looks good. Speed looks good. I gotta get my speed up. Get it up. No, not. Okay, get it down. Up. There we go. Man, I'm sweating. There's probably sharks in that water. I don't want to crash. I've seen what sharks can do. Especially in Nintendo video games. Oh god, no, I'm too fast. No, I'm gonna fall off. Oh my god. Dude, I just landed. 38 years old, I landed. Oh my god, well, I've never been to Mission 2. What do I have to do here? I gotta destroy an enemy aircraft carrier, okay. First attempt, landed it. I, honest to God, have never landed that. Even the first level. I'm feeling pretty cocky now. I gotta figure out how to take off. There we go. Okay. Wow. At this point, I'm considering this a win. Like, I might just parachute out of my cockpit and just leave. I can't do that because I got bananas. Okay, they're jets. Look like bananas. I thought we were in some training mission with bananas. Yeah, I just don't have it anymore. I already did what I set aside to do, so I'm not really too concerned about this level. I mean, they can shoot at me all they want. As I said, I'm going to press this button any moment and just parachute out. Man, that music is rocking. What's rocking right now is this banana aircraft. I'm in danger. Get out. Get out of their radar. Left. Go right. Okay. I'm getting a little cocky. I'm not going to lie. I landed on my first carrier. So I'm basically like a general now. I'm probably in talks to star in Top Gun 3 right now, actually. I wasn't supposed to say that, but they saw me playing this game and they said, hey, Tom's getting old. I've seen what you can do on e-bikes. We need you, so I'll let you guys know if we come to an agreement. And I'm shooting at these ships, I don't even care. I've already landed on a ship. I'd rather land on a ship than shoot a ship. Getting pretty low with my altitude there. Oh man, I crashed, that's too bad. Am I still back at it though? Of course I'm back at it. I'm gonna take that ship down, boom. Landed on a ship, and then I just killed a ship. I'm just flying to the right now. Going out for a country cruise out on the Pacific Ocean. I got all kinds of things coming at me. Man, dead twice. I'm gonna give it another try, though. I am freaking pumped, man, that I landed that. And you guys are watching this, and you're probably, oh, it's so simple. I did that when I was 7 months old. Well, kudos, you probably did. It took me 38 years, almost 39 years of age to land that. So, Hakuna Matata. I'm about to say Hakuna Matata to this ship right here. Watch this. Watch what I do to this ship. Okay, watch this. That actually looks like a killer whale. I think that's Willy. I think I just killed Free Willy, actually. There's the ship. This is what I do to it. Watch it. Kudos. Bye-bye. Two of you. And then they finally catch up with me. So, hey, game over. I succeeded. Mark the date and time. It is like 9:30-ish p.m. Monday. I didn't do the time thing. Monday, December, whatever it is. And I just absolutely dominated the first game that I cannot dominate. So we got one down. Let's go ahead and go to the second game and see if I can excel more than I could back in the day. Stage two of my childhood horror was the cult classic Paperboy. Not the easy Paperboy 2. This is the original one. And as you can see, red is bad. Alright, I guess they're going to show me the houses I need to do first. I don't know what that was about. So blue is, hey, here's your paper. I'm going to throw it right on your doorstep. Red is, I'm probably going to break your window, and you're going to come out and try to break my face. So 6 a.m., I'm up on an early Monday before school, riding my 10-speed Huffy. I'm already 0 for 2. I did throw that in the garage, so I'm going to consider that a win. But this game absolutely drove me nuts as a kid, and I found it a lot harder now than I did as a kid, and that seems to be a running theme. And I just had a tire that had to be haunted, change directions, and run into me. So again, the white houses I'm throwing papers at, red houses I'm not supposed to, but I guess I just felt like giving them one. So I'm going very slow. It's like my first time on a 10-speed bike, and Miss Cleo comes running after me. Luckily I'm on a 10-speed and I'm on gear 10, and we got some crazy man after me too. Some kid on a all-terrain vehicle. Where's his parents? That was dangerous. Boom! Hit a boom. And I somehow ran into a green 1932 vehicle. So I don't know what that 1932 vehicle was doing in 1980s, but I ran into it again. At this point, I probably got to have a broken arm or a broken leg. I don't think this 50 cents an hour I'm making throwing these commercial news. Oh, that was perfect. I shut up because I thought that was a perfect one. So right here, no stop sign. I'm running the road. Some guy out there having a seizure. I just let him be. And some policeman jacking off, looks like. So I'm just... Oh, man. And I'm running into those sewer things. I guess you can't avoid them. I called it quits already. I called it quits on my first Monday. So I need to learn how to be a paperboy. Give me just a few moments here. Alright, just got some sound advice from Ricky the Paperboy. San Francisco Paperboy of the year 1989 to 1993. As always, thanks again, Ricky. So after speaking with Ricky, he told me the technique. Obviously, I wasn't doing it correctly, so we're going to try this again. It's next Monday. Again, I'm up before school. Boom, right into the garage. Picked up some extra papers. That one I was a little off. And now a lawnmower man is attacking me. Boom, I'm rocking and rolling. Again, the white houses are what you want to hit. Red houses are satanic blood cults, and you do not want to give them a paper because you will get fired and you will lose out on the $1.75 you're making for 6 hours of work. And killed by the tire again, the demonic possessed tire that can switch directions. And I also get ran over by looks like Butnick from Salute Your Shorts out on a skateboard. So this next Monday is not doing too good, and I think at this point I'm just pissed off. I about get run over there. My tires are low, and the reason this game is part of this is because, well, hold on, I'm getting chased again by a half-naked elderly lady. The reason I put this game on here is because, as I recall, and I could be wrong, I never made it past the first level on this game either. I think when I played this game, I was a little bit younger than the others. I'll have to see when it came out, but I remember the red houses being bad, and you can see the tombstones there. And I remember the White House as being good, so trying to play off of that as a kid, I thought it was pretty easy. For some reason, I think it's harder to play on a PC as well. I don't know why, but like right there, how am I supposed to see what's coming ahead? I ran into the 1993 Geo Metro, and then I got ran over again by the dude on the skateboard. And of course, I run into a sewer. And then of course, just to spin on my grave, a tire gets me. So you know what? Called it quits again. Ricky gave me advice, not good enough advice. San Francisco must not be as dangerous as insert my local town. But you know what? We're gonna try one more time. Those are my local customers. All the ones in red basically kicked me out. So I've only got maybe four or five houses to go. Trying again on a Monday before school. Sun's just coming up. I'm half asleep. One paper in a garage, which I don't know if it's supposed to go there. But I should mention with this, I am playing these games with the $5 USB controller again. A little bit easier to play these games than to play games like Punch-Out and stuff like that. So the guy's obviously having a seizure again. And there's a barking dog somewhere in this game, and I swear it's not my dog barking in the other room. So I died again, and this is where we currently stand. We're gonna give it one more try. Again, White House, throw the paper. I just broke two windows. That's 7 months of papering just to cover those windows, so I don't know what we're gonna do with that. Broke another window. I avoided the teenager on the skateboard, thank God. I inches from getting hit. Again, no stop sign, no cops patrolling. This is a very dangerous location. The late 80s must have been a terrible time to live in this town if you're a paperboy. There's a dog not on a leash or anything, just hanging out. And a dog barking again. So at this point, ladies chasing me again. Lawnmowers chasing me as always. I've convinced myself that this place is haunted. I've convinced myself that my parents only want to stay here because they want me to be scared and want me to live my life in fear. So I've now come to a realization that whether I complete this paper route or not, as soon as these papers are gone, I'm ditching this town. I'm getting out of here. I can't make it anywhere. Paper route is too tough. And look at this. On the side of the road, there's just a trail. I don't know what's going on. I'm not Dave Mira. And I wreck. So is at this point, I officially gave up on being a 38-year-old paperboy. I would probably say I did better as a kid, but honestly, I don't think I got much farther as a kid. So this is the second game. I'm 1-for-2 right now, 50%. I'll take it. Let's go ahead and go to the third and final game and see if I can do better than I did as a kid. So judging by this fantastic start where I did not hit the gas and I stood there for 2 to 3 seconds, I think the answer to this is probably going to be no. I loved this game as a kid. Unfortunately, I was never good at it. I do not believe that I ever made it to the second stage. Second stage, I mean, you get beyond the trucks. I think you have to collect the word Nintendo, which just collected the N. So I don't think I ever did it. So we're going to give it a few attempts here. Races are super quick. That orange bastard beat me for first place. Ain't nothing wrong with silver. You know, that's what Kyle Knowlton Jr. used to always say. Ain't nothing wrong with silver. But we're going to the second race, and at this point, I'm not going to take second anymore. I've determined the orange guy is my arch nemesis. We've got some treacherous shit going on this racetrack. I don't think they should be allowing us to race on this kind of racetrack. There's oil, there's guns. I just crashed into the side of the road. There's oil, there's ammunition. Watch this. I take full advantage of the ammunition. I'm not gonna lie, I cheat to win. Orange guy, took him out. Second race, I finished numero uno. Also, I collected the eyes, so I've got Nih for Nintendo. And you see my car is just getting stacked up. And again, terrible start. I don't know if I'm taking a nap. I don't know if I'm on my phone, but I'm not very good at these starts. Again, road is terrible, and my car/truck absolutely just got demolished. Now, not only are we dealing with these weapons and stuff, and wet spots, and oil, and all kinds of crazy stuff, but now, I guess I forgot to get the other end, so I risk track positioning to get the end, and I'm out of it right now, so I gotta make a quick comeback. I got one lap. There you go. I made my way back up. I'm hitting the zoom zooms. And there's the orange bastard again, my arch nemesis, and he beats me again. So three races, I've got two silvers and a gold. There you see, tires getting better, my turbo's getting good. And this one, I believe now, not only do we have all these weapons, but now we have some backfire. So now not only can I shoot people from the front of my red Honda, I can shoot them from the ass of my red Honda. So, and if I can shoot from anywhere, I'm gonna do it. I believe this is the one where I just went absolutely crazy with shooting people. Well, I tried to hit green, but Mr. Joe Diffie got by me. I don't know if I catch him, I can't remember, but I hit the zoom, but I didn't zoom enough. And I finished dead freaking last. The fourth track, game over already. Good thing about this game is it's never game over. If it's game over, you can just hit enter, and I think it lets you do it a couple times, so. Put in DZZ, I have no idea what that stands for. But I'm gonna give it another go, because, again, as a child, this was a game that I could never get to the second level, and that was my goal before completing this. So it started me off at the same level. I'm going left, I'm going right, I'm drunk, I'm not gonna lie. I had a couple Coors Lights and some Smirnoff. I had a girl drink, okay, before I went out on this red truck. And I crashed, DUI, drunk driver, insurance just went up, terrible. Don't do what I do, kids, on this game. Don't drink and drive in this truck, because you'll wreck like I did. Now watch this. Watch the orange guy here. I think this is where he absolutely just goes insane. You can see the... Okay, it's not this race. Sorry. The good thing is I qualified because I got third. Bronze is not everyone's favorite trophy, but it'll get you to the next level. There you see both levels, everything. I got two bars full. And I've got the E and Nintendo. I believe... Once I get Nintendo, I think it lets me go to the next level. I'm not entirely sure. Again, I don't think I've ever made it past this. And this is a game I've probably not played at all. Oh, watch the orange guy at the bottom. Like, look at that. You can't tell me he's not got an illegal, like, restrictor plate or something going on. That man is doing something. Because there's no way. Look at this. Look, he's going to lap us. And I'm in second. And he just finished before we barely started the last lap. Good thing is it allowed me to finish second. I got my third silver, and I bumped up my engine. So now we're going to the next race. Again, terrible conditions. My tires have got to be shot. I've wrecked this bastard like four times. It's held together by hopes and dreams and cheap Elmer's glue at this point. And I don't have enough speed to keep up with these, keep up with these guys. But I'm doing my best, you know? I'm trying to hit them zoom zooms. I'm trying to hit these angles just right, get a little Tokyo drift going on. And I'm not against wrecking my competitors, which I did right there. As long as I finish in the top three and I collect the letter, which I just got the D, so I am now super close to having a Nintendo, which I think allows me to advance to the next stage, I think. We got one lap to go. I'm in second, and look, go to last. That is how quick this game will tear your heart out. I'm trying to catch up. I'm trying. Look how close I was. So something's got to change here. Give me just a few moments again. All right, after that brief break, I do have my number three Intimidator hat on, so I'm going to do it for Dale, just like the sign says up there. Intimidation's going to be what I'm going to factor on, what I'm going to count on this race. I'm going to shoot people. I'm going to ram people. I'm going to intimidate people because this is like my main man, Dale Jr., 1998 at Daytona. I need to come through with the W here because I am one letter away. Actually, I just got it. I've got Nintendo. All I got to do is finish, and I will make it, from what I've read, to the second round of this game that I have never done. 38 years of life, I have never done this, and I'm going to do it for Dale. Truly, everything in this game is going to be for Dale. I'm going to shoot people for Dale. I'm going to get that DUI for Dale that I got earlier. That was for Dale. Luckily, this is a longer race because it allowed me to not finish third, which, hey, third would have been okay, but I want to win it for Dale. Can I win it for Dale at the end? Can I win it for Dale? No. I crash. Just like Dale did. I crashed. I didn't make it. But the good thing is I get to start all over. But you know what? Let's fast forward to the end. Let's not make us watch all this again because I didn't give up. All right, so here we go. I ran a few more races. I made it to the last race again. Look at the bottom. I'm just missing the O. Got it on the first lap. All I got to do is just not get last, and I will do what I have not done my whole life. I could not do something my whole life that I just did on a Monday night to record on YouTube. That's got to be something absolutely special. But I've got to not die. So, orange guy's in dead last. Thank God. Green guy, I'm shooting to kill. Dale, again, I got the Intimidator mode. And I'm not gonna let it happen. It's been a long time coming. I'm one lap away. I'm waiting for that white flag to wave. I'm so close. Here we go, last lap. I just gotta get past these guys. I can't wreck, just don't finish last, and I'm in dead last. But luckily I hit those zooms, and there's the orange guy who is not. Oh, he wrecks me right at the end, but I get lucky because he crosses the finish line. I was about to get absolutely dead last. And look down there, spelling off Nintendo. I've done it. Three games. I've completed two of my goals. And there you see the cars. Let's not even get into that. This did not last very long. But guys, girls, YouTube, thank you so much for watching this video. This, again, is something different than my e-bike videos. Content like this is going to come across because it's winter time and I can't do a whole lot of e-bike riding. So I like doing things like this. This is probably a little bit longer than what I want to do in the future. I was going to make three separate videos, but hey, let's just make one. So as always, thank you guys for watching. Like, subscribe, leave a comment, do all that good stuff. Propose marriage. Thank you for spending your time, helping me waste my time, and I thank you, as does the Intimidator, and I have now completed the challenge.